plan, build, test, redesign. Does this sound familiar? The engineering design process is similar to the scientific method. It helps break down the problem-solving process into a simple step-by-step process.
In order to help children to get acquainted with these methods and gain problem-solving skills, here are some guidelines at each phase of the engineering design process.
No engineer starts to build without a plan, just like no scientist starts an experiment without a hypothesis. Make sure children start off by creating a design plan so they decide on what materials they want to use before. If they get stuck, you can try giving them words of encouragement. How about I help you start with your plan? Do you have any idea of how you want your machine to work?
I want to make a machine that spins super fast using a balloon.
Okay, nice. Well, you know, engineers and scientists always create a detailed plan before they begin any project. So let's start to sketch and label some of the different pieces of your machine.
I don't really want to draw. I know exactly what I want to make. It's in my head.
Okay. How about I help you get started with drawing and then you can continue. Let's take a look at the materials table and see if there's anything there that might inspire you. So you already have a really great plan, but let's try adding a little more detail.
Okay, so what do you suggest?
Let's try adding some arrows to show which direction your prototype will move.
Okay, so I have the cup pointing to the straw, and the straw to the balloon, and the balloon to the paperclip.
Nice. Once the plan is ready, it's time to build. Sometimes children have trouble following their plan, and they get discouraged with building. Try sitting down with them and start building together. Involve the family as much as possible to encourage the child.
Mom, can you get started? Let's take a look at the plan and figure out what the first step should be.
Okay, well, maybe using the cup.
Testing will help prove whether or not your design was successful. Make sure you have a spacious testing station for children and their parents. It's important that the child takes note of the problems that their prototype faces when tested, just like you learned from the errors in your own work. In order to make the child aware of the importance of testing stage, try asking questions before testing their design. What do you think is going to happen when we test the prototype?
I think it'll spin.
Okay. How do you think it'll spin? In what direction?
Maybe this way?
Okay. All right. Well, let's try it out and see. Ready?
One, two, three.
Okay. So what did we learn from the test?
I learned that it needs a stronger supporting structure. It's tilting to the side.
Okay. What do you think we can do to modify the design to maybe help it spin a little better?
I think we could tape the cup to the table.
Okay. What do you think would happen if we turned one of the balloons in the opposite direction? Do you think that would help it spin more or less?
More, probably.
All right. Well, let's try it out and see what happens. Redesigning is another pivotal step to encourage the families to create multiple design iterations. Great, so I see you guys had an opportunity to redesign your prototype.
Yeah, we changed the direction of the balloons and so that they're opposite, and now we're ready to test.
One, two, three.
Since the engineering design process is an iterative process, it's important to reinforce to the families that failure is not an outcome, but part of the learning process. As they see what works and what doesn't work as their prototype is tested, you can emphasize that persisting through failure is critical to being a successful engineer.
Finally, the last piece of the engineering design process is reflection. We encourage families to share, discuss, and reflect on the project that they built. Try using open-ended questions that families can answer to provide some insight on the engineering design process, their project, and building together. We recommend coming up with at least 3 questions to ask the families during reflection. The next module will introduce you to open-ended questions.
Now that you know what feedback to use for engineering design process, prepare with a few phrases, questions, or comments related to the challenge you chose to run. This way, you'll be ready to provide encouragement and support to the families.